Thank you very much, and it's a pleasure to be here and to tell you all about our new science that we have developed to better understand Alterion. So before I move into all our new exciting data, I would like to discuss a little bit with you about the basics of Bacillus to remind us why germination is so important. So when we deliver out the Alterion product, it's in a spore form, meaning that it's actually an inactive format of the Bacillus delivered to the animals. That is a very big advantage in the feed, because you would like a product that is very stable, and it can also survive together with a durable biological structure. But it's also an inactive form. And what is then interesting is, how do we then get this inactive form to germinate and become active? And what we have discovered through our science is that really, when you look at different strains of Bacillus, they have very different capability to germinate. So let's look a little bit more into what is it that triggers germination of your product. So in this next slide is a really, you can say, simplified version of how a spore look. You can see it's a very robust feature where you have inside really the DNA of the Bacillus, and then it has a double layer coating, meaning that it has this very strong capability to survive almost all exposures from the outside. But of course you need this inactive form to come alive, and that's the way that is triggered is that these spores, they have receptors that are sensing the environment, and they are really sensitive to different germinants, like amino acids, different carbohydrates, but also temperature and moisture. And that is really what is triggering their ability to germinate. And that's also why different bacillus will be very different in how they can germinate. Some will have some very sensitive receptors, and some will be more resistant to start germinating. So why is it that germination is so important? Well, that is because, as I said, the Bacillus spore is really an inactive form. And in order to get your product activity, you need the Bacillus to wake up, you can say, inside the animals, start to divide, start to multiply, and start to become metabolically active. That is the form of the product that you need inside the animals to get the effects. And what is happening really inside the animal, when you get the germination, when you get the motile and active cells, is that they can produce several hundred metabolites, giving all the beneficial effects to the animal. So that is why it's really key to understand the germination of the product. So how did we study this? Well, I can tell you that it is a very, very complex process to look into germination due to the complexity of the host environment. And that is also why we know that for many years it's been really unknown how good Bacillus strain is at germinating inside the animal. And that is also why we have looked at this feature from, you can say, many different angles. So it's been looked at first in vitro, and then we have moved into developing this new technology to also look inside the animal, and also adding to that, what kind of metabolites do we actually see in the animals. And if I start on the in vitro part of things, then this is a very nice tool for your first step of understanding germination. Because as I said earlier, different kinds of bacillus have different capabilities to germinate. So this can be a very nice first understanding of your Bacillus strains. Of course, in vitro studies are also always very simple compared to what is happening in the animal, but you can for sure use it as a first step. So here we have in rich media grown several different Bacillus strains and looked at what are their, you can say, basic capability to germinate if they have a very good environment. And in this graph, for example, you can see three different Bacillus strains and you have the time at the bottom and the capability to germinate on the y-axis. And here you can see an example of three strains where it's quite clear that it's different when they start to germinate and how many of the cells are germinating. What we have seen when we study this in vitro is that it can actually vary from everything to few hours to up to more than 18 hours before a Bacillus strain will germinate. So you see it's really important to understand this feature. Here is an example comparing two different strains of Bacillus, where you can also see again that they are extremely different. The first one is an Bacillus amyloliquefaciens, and we filmed it for 18 hours, and you can see here that actually this strain has completely lost its ability to germinate, so they stay in the spore format. And that's of course not the format you would like inside the animal. If you then compare to the Alterion strain, it's quite obvious that after a few hours, you will see that they start not only to germinate, but also to divide. So you can see you get a lot of extra cells every time the Bacillus are dividing. I can just take it one more time. So you see here, maybe around 50 Bacillus spores are here, but then as soon as they start to germinate and also multiply, you get several extra cells. This is another picture where we also have a time course of Alterion, where we had looked at the germinating kinetics also in vitro, where you can see we have studied it after 4 and 6 hours to see if the strain has a good capability to germinate in a time span that is relevant inside a chicken. And the last in vitro studies we did, which also have great importance when you talk about feed and the probiotics, is that you should have a strain that has good germination capabilities in the gut in combination with other products that are relevant in the feed. So these graphs show you that you can mix Alterion with different feedstuffs. Here it's corn, soy, and wheat, and you will have a similar germination profile of the product. These studies have also been done with several other feed components, like different acids, coccidiostats, and other relevant feed ingredients, to really see that that your strain is still capable of becoming active inside the animal, no matter the feed composition. And the next step is when it gets really exciting, because this is where we start to get look at the completely new data that we have seen for the first time with a Bacillus strain in chicken. And this is moving into really understanding what is happening inside the animal. For this, we have developed a new technology, and that is what is sketched here. And what we have aimed at here is to not only, you can say, measure the germination, but actually be able to see it with our eyes. And the way we have done this is that we have taken our Alterion strain and then we have added some markers to the strain. And these markers are fluorescent. And we have actually added not only one, but two markers. And that means that we are able to visualize the spores, that meaning the inactive form, they will fluoresce green. Then when we add it to the animal, for example, and they start to germinate and become active, then we have added another marker, which is red, meaning that the active germinated cells of Alterion will be red. So if you look at the picture here, you can see all the green dots, that will be Alterion spores, and the red ones are then the ones that have started to germinate and grow. And one thing that's very important to say is that this red marker is linked not only to germination, but also cells that are starting to divide and become metabolically active. So then after developing this strain, we of course wanted to add it to the animals and see, okay, what is then happening when we give this product to the animals? And that was very exciting to see. So we gave the animals this type of Alterion for some days, and then we took out samples from the gut and analyzed where the germination was taking place. And then you can then visualize the germination. If you see the red fluorescent, you have a proof that the strain has become active and germinated. And these are some pictures from the ileum of the bird. And here we see a very strong signal proving, really for the first time to us, that the germination of Alterion takes place exactly where we want it to take place. So in the control birds, you can see, you don't see germination. There's a few red dots there, probably some artifacts. But in the Alterion-fed birds, you can really see a strong red signal indicating that germination, yes, it does take place. And yes, we have a strain that is really becoming active inside the birds. I can also tell you, and I don't have the pictures here, but we also analyzed further up in the intestine. And of course, we don't want the germination to happen, for example, in the crop or in the proventriculus, because the vegetative cells will not like that environment. The pH, for example, is too low, but we did not see any germination there. Whereas further down in the jejunum, the ileum, and also in the cica, we had germination taking place. So I can say it's one picture here, but it's really amazing to see that we do have the germination in exactly the right place. And in my last slide, it's just a short summary to tell you that yes, this new technology has helped us to the first time show in the animals that we have timely germination. Of course, based on a lot of initial work selecting the strain based on in vitro characteristics, but now also proved in the animals and also actually proved that this growth is leading to production of a lot of very important metabolites, which will be the topic of the next slide, the next speaker, sorry. So with that, I want to thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you will have some good questions. We are happy to answer.